coming in for landing in 3, 2, 1.
We are gonna be building a Halo drop pod.
I don't think this is such a good idea.
Okay, I'll fail!
Ever since I was a little boy, my favorite video game of all time was Halo. I couldn't play a single game without wearing my fully functioning Master Chief 9000 costume. I thought it made me better at the game. But sometimes I would lose and my temper would get the best of me. But there was one thing about Halo that I loved. More than the Master Chief, more than Cortana, it was drop pods. Sometimes I'd lie on the grass outside my house and stare into the sky, imagining that one day I, too, could fly down from space in a drop pod. And then I had the idea. Why don't I?
Hey, yo, what's going on, guys? It's the Master Chief. And before the video starts, I have an important mission for you to defeat the Covenant. The only way we can do it is if you like and share this video. Share it with a fellow Spartan and defeat the Covenant. All right, Master Chief out.
Because it's me. It's actually me. It's Papa Jake. I know, I've probably fooled you guys because I look so much like Master Chief. But hey, what's going on, everyone? We're back with a brand new video. And today, guys, we are doing something I have actually wanted to do my entire life. It is also probably the most dangerous Papa Jake video we have ever done. So let me repeat that. Dangerous. So whatever you hear or see in this video, do not try at home. Even if I happen to pick up a bottle of water and drink it. Don't try it at home, because it's dangerous. But guys, today we are gonna be building a Halo drop pod. Now, if you guys don't know what a drop pod is, it's not only in Halo, it's in a lot of video games. It is a pod that allows you to drop from space or an airplane, crash into the ground, open the door, kick it open, and start taking down your enemies with your skills. The only problem is, they don't exist in real life. Probably because if you dropped from an airplane in a box, it wouldn't end well. But that's not stopping us, because we have gone through many years of box fort building technology, and me, myself, know everything there is to know about box forts. Now, I asked Logan, and he said that this was extremely dangerous, and he wanted no part of it. Which is why I called up the smartest person I know, Philip. Phil! Phil, get in here! Now, Phil is actually the only one here who's graduated college. Isn't that right, Phil?
Yeah, I guess so.
And what did you graduate in?
Cooking!
Now, although cooking may have nothing to do with physics, nor dropping a drop pod from a high height, Phil does have the knowledge of college within inside him, which is why he'll be my lead man on this. Now, the objective for this is simple. We have to design a box fort that can drop from 15 feet, allowing me to reach the ground safely. If I am able to get up and I'm not injured or fallen on my side, I'll then have to reach and grab a nerf blaster, exit the drop pod, and take out two enemies. If I'm able to do that, then that means the mission is a success. If I fall and spray my ankle, mission over. If I fall on the front and can't get out, mission over. If this thing catches on fire and Phil has to put me out, mission over. Also, maybe Papa Jake over. So yeah, that's dangerous. But I've got a plan.
I don't think this is such a good idea.
Phil, you're starting to sound like Logan. It is a great idea, all right? Soaring through the sky, dropping down, taking out enemies.
You're in a box fort!
No. Not just a box fort. A special box fort. Check this out. So as you guys know, the plan is pretty simple. You have a box like so, but if we're gonna be dropping from 15 feet, I'm gonna need some reinforcement. That's why, if I were to make it 3D, that's right, we've got that technology. We're gonna have air mattresses on all three sides of the box fort. So we'll have an air mattress on this side, an air mattress on this side, and an air mattress on the back of the box fort, like so. The top doesn't really need anything, but we'll probably put some sort of, you know, aerial deflector shield thing here, AKA an umbrella. Then the front will have the door, because I need a way to get in and outside the fort. And the bottom will be using a massive inflatable. Now inside the fort, we'll have some reinforced padding, along with some LED lights, electronics, my Nerf blaster. Once this is ready, we are going to use a pulley system to hoist it up on a wood beam that is 15 feet up in the air. When I say go, Phil will drop this and it will fall 15 feet to the nice flat ground. If all goes well, I'll get out of that and take down the Covenant. If not, then I'm gonna get hurt real bad. Okay guys, so I just sent Phil to the store to get a bunch of stuff that we're gonna use to make this drop pod as sick and also as safe as possible, because you know, I'm number one safety guy. Okay, maybe I'm not. Oh, Phil?
And it looks like Phil the man is here, the rocket
Jake,
scientist.
I don't know what you're doing.
All right, so Phil, I'll explain everything once it's on the ground. Okay.
Well, basically, you guys know the simple concept is gonna be the square of the box fort. That part's easy, but we are gonna have to do a few tests with our safety inflatables to make sure they work.
Phil, this is what you bought for the bottom?
Yeah, you told me to get a floaty.
Phil, this is for a small child. This is not gonna take the weight of me as I drop from 15 feet. Why are we putting these bad boys on the side and these small, it was a watermelon floaty?
Okay, maybe I was a little hungry when I bought the watermelon floaty.
Yeah, thanks, Phil! You haven't given me any donuts today!
Okay, so there might be an issue because if I'm falling 15 feet down, we're gonna have the weight of the actual drop pod itself plus the weight of me, which is 200 pounds of pure muscle. That's a lot of weight.
And there we go, guys. We've got the first oh, it's a little squishy. First sighting of the drop pod, all ready to go. So the concept for this is if, you know, the drop pod were to fall on its side, then you would land on this. Again, I don't know why we're putting the beastiest stuff on the sides, but I mean, if you're falling, oh, okay, I think I broke something. Cancel the video. It really hurts. Phil!
Hey, Jake!
No, Phil!
I don't need CPR!
I don't need CPR, Phil! I hurt my leg! No, do not do CPR on me.
Okay, maybe we just need to inflate them a bit more.
All right, guys, so check it out. We have all of the inflatables completely filled up that we are gonna use for the drop pod, including the most important one, the bottom piece, which is a watermelon. But before we can even do this, we do need to test out the stability of them. That is why Phil has offered, and let me rephrase that, Phil has offered, I told him he didn't have to do it, but he wants to jump onto the inflatables. Phil, are you sure about that? That's a bit of a high jump here, bud.
You're going for 15 feet, Jake! I can go for 5!
Okay, I'll fail! did it hurt?
I think you're gonna be alright!
Okay! Guys, inflatables for the win! Phil, you wanna do that again, but on this one?
Ooh, I don't know about that.
See what I mean? This is the most important piece, and it's at the bottom.
Okay, well, we got the inflatables, and of course,
we also have all the stuff we're gonna use to hoist it up. We also got some emergency blankets so we can make the inside look cool, because obviously it's still a box fort. We gotta make the inside all Halo-themed, because this is a Halo-themed drop pod.
And I brought road flares. Don't know why I bought them, but maybe if you hit that like button, we'll light one of these road flares up. Okay, but now that we've done that, it's time to actually start building this thing. So we're gonna grab our cardboard, grab our tape, and start putting together the world's first ever Halo drop pod. And if you or you know someone who works for the Army and they wanna purchase this, please feel free to show them this video because this is future military tech. Yo guys, so check this thing out. It's coming along and it is looking crazy. So we've got all three of the sides of the drop pod put together. We've got Phil holding the back side, which is going to basically go here. And then once it is put in like that, as you guys can see, I'm gonna have a chair in here and then we're also gonna have a floor. And underneath the floor is going to be the circular inflatable, which is what we're gonna use to basically stop this thing. So once I'm in here, I'm in my chair, I'm in my Master Chief costume. I'll have, you know, my blasters on the wall, maybe some security stuff. We'll make this look really cool. Definitely some LED lights. And then I'm gonna go up 15 feet. Maybe I'll have a window so I can see out and then drop straight down. And hopefully I don't explode. You know what? I actually feel pretty safe. But again, the challenge isn't all about safety. I still, once I drop, have to be able to open the front door, grab a blaster, and take out two enemies. Even if I land without hurting myself, that's only half the challenge.
But all right, let's get the last part on here, and then we can flip it over and then start working on the underside of it. The drop pod is almost complete. Check this thing out. It is looking insane. We have our chair inside. We haven't decked it out fully, and of course, we're gonna put one of those like classic drop pod doors on here that you can like kick open once you land, hopefully landing flat and straight like this. But as you can see,
I'll have my Master Chief costume on. I will sit inside the drop pod in the chair. I'll have access to all the control panels, everything like that. I'll have my blaster on the side here. Probably have some medical stuff. And we still have to put the shock absorber system on the bottom. Okay, guys, so check this thing out. The pod is looking so sweet. It is really beasty and massive. We've got the inflatables on all sides, and I've created this door, which works as not only a door, but it also is going to be the thing that I basically kick off once I land on the ground. We're gonna secure it with just a minimal amount of tape, and then check out the inside of the pod. We've got running LEDs, we've got our blaster here, so we've got our halo blaster, we've got a pistol, we've also got some technical wires and stuff like that. The cool thing about this is you can sit inside and basically you can like look around, you can see everything, and then you'll be able to see it through a small slit. I added the viewing slit because I thought if I am gonna fall from 15 feet, I wanna at least be able to see what's going on. And then up here, we've got some control panel stuff. We've got the drop button, and then we've got the door explode button. So it's looking pretty good. I'm excited. I'm gonna go put my Master Chief costume on. I wanna run a small test inside the house before we actually hoist this thing up 15 feet in the air. And hey, maybe if it works, we go higher and higher and higher. All right, so the next thing we need to do is put the door back on, finalize a couple of things. I need to get back in my Master Chief costume. I gotta admit, guys, I'm a little scared. So comment down below if you think this is going to work. I have no idea. Phil, what are you doing? Emergency flare, not for it. Phil, get it out of here.
I thought you wanted it in the
pod. Phil, what are you doing?
I thought you wanted it in the pod.
No, get it, Phil.
That's an emergency flare, Phil.
You said it was going in the fort.
Yeah, as an emergency if I were to land off center and I need to, you know, signal someone not to bring inside the fort, Phil.
All right, now that that's over with, it's Master Chief time.
All right, guys, we are officially inside the drop pod doing a test of what it will be like when I drop. As you guys can see, we are squeezed in here in our Master Chief armor. We've got our blaster to the left. Everything is good to go. It is now time to test this thing out. Now, I do have some enemies that I've set up, so this is gonna be a full real life test. Once the door blasts off, I'll have to get out of here, grab my blaster, and take them out. All right, engines are ready. Cortana, we're good to drop. Remember, guys, if you think I can do this in real life, smash that like button and comment down below. Activating drop coordinates on the drop switch now. Coordinates are locked in. Disconnecting safety lever from spaceship's drive. All right, we are clear for dropping. All right, and we are dropping in 3, 2, 1, drop. All right, guys, we're entering down into the atmosphere. We are moving, drop pod is holding. Everything is good. Cryo smoke is leaking slightly. And coming in for landing in 3, 2, 1. All right, we've landed. Opening door now. Got an enemy up there. Down. Moving. Second enemy. Out of ammo. All right, guys. Well, this has been the Halo Box for Drop Pod. If you guys loved it, smack that like button because we are gonna be dropping this 15 feet up in the air if we get 15,000 likes. Every 1,000 like this video gets, we will go higher, up to 20 feet, because then I will legitimately hurt myself. So smack that like button down below, share this video with a friend if you like Halo, and we'll see you guys next time for another awesome video.